Hey guys, Tekken Gaming here, back with the Pokemon Glazed long play, which has actually been doing really well on my channel, so thank you all for that. But as you can see here, if you saw the grinding episode, I trained several people up to the level where they could easily just be yanked out of the box and used. So, specifically these five that I had not trained up before. It's Cottonee, Floatzel, Nidoking, Golurk, and whoa! The Gyarados. They are all trained up now, have good movesets and everything. Yeah. So now, I believe we are going to go battle some more Team Fusion dudes. Yeah. So I did swap Whirl onto the team again. This is actually a really cool area because it loops. See? There's the cave entrance where we came in. The two guys standing guard. So, it's a really cool effect. What's up? Oh, hi Pikachu. Bonk. Oh, that's not good. That's how it goes. So now we gotta go to like the fusion labs or whatever. Yeah, right here. Oh, okay. That works too. Rock slide. I would get rid of rock smash, but you want to learn it? Yeah. Yeah, your attacking stats are like perfectly even. Okay. Very cool. that's to be fair. Did I say that's to be fair? I meant that's to be expected, and that's fair at the same time. Oh my gosh. Okay. Rock type gym. Water type Pokemon. Although you're also flying type, so. You know what? I have the perfect solution for this. Somebody that's not gonna help in a rock type gym is gonna be you. Somebody that is gonna help is gonna be you. Somebody else that's gonna help is gonna be you. Somebody else that's not gonna help is gonna be you. So look at that. That's what's good about having people trained up to levels easily switchable in. You can just switch them in, and there you go. Okay, Floatzel. Aqua Jet. Oh, that's great. Okay, Fracture. Oh, come on. Well, I mean, you're at plus two now, so. Yeah, makes sense. Good, good. Armaldo. You reached a rock slide, yeah. Oh, it missed. Are you kidding? Earthquake does about as much, so. Shuckle, oh. I'm gonna use this chance to heal up Gyarados. And then switch him in, because you have no HP, even though you have good defenses. I have Dragon Rage, and so I can do this enough that you will just die. Well, I mean, I'm gonna run out of power points if you don't. Oh my gosh. Okay, critical hit, and then, yeah, finally. Cradily. Okay, so you're neutral to that. I couldn't remember if rock resisted poison or not. Grass doesn't resist fighting, so there's that. Awesome. Rock tomb. Nice. Tyson all the way in Darkwood. Yeah. I think I'm gonna put Golurk on the team. Now we got Rock Climb. Can anybody on my team learn Rock Climb? Oh, you can. Awesome. It's better than Rollout. Rollout has the potential to be very good, but like, that's just three of them hitting in a row, and has almost the same accuracy, so. Do you go over here? No, that's that room. Okay. There's nothing to do in this room. One second. Okay. I've, like, been through here before. I just don't remember the way through. Right, so this is... Oh, yeah. Okay. This is North Coast, okay. Is it down here? Oh, that's just how you get to this area, yeah, okay. This is just this small area. Do not have strength on anyone that's on my team right now. See, that's one bad thing about changing up your team so much. You don't always have the HMs because you don't remember who you taught them to when you needed them. Aha, we go across here. Yeah, die. Ah, here they are. The hooligans. You're dead. Is no surprise. Ooh. That's a bad matchup. Magnitude. Very cool. I'll switch you to the front because you need experience. Very cool. I realized I could have been using Drain Punch because he's actually weak to it. Scraggy is, but that's okay. I do not have Waterfall. Yet. See, that's a great opportunity for that. Magnitude 10, and then I get roared away. Very nice. You're dead. Very cool. All right. I'm pretty sure I've done that on like every playthrough of Glazed I've ever done. I heal up at that like little cave right there after fighting all the fusion dudes, and then there's a healing hiker right after it. I gotta say I like this like ghostly effect in the background whenever you're doing moves like the woo, you know. Looks cool. You're going easy, you swear, really? Okay. Bonk. Oh. I mean, there's really no reason not to run back and heal so often. Put Fracture in front. He's the next to evolve, and by that I mean he's the only one on my team that isn't fully evolved. He evolves at 48, I'm pretty sure. There isn't a location title here. That's lovely music. Pretty sure it's from Johto. Mount Stratus. Team Fusion Mount Stratus music. By Jove! I don't think I've ever heard somebody say that in real life. Maybe just because I'm not British.
Bowler.
I was working at a supermarket a while back, and this lady came in that was like really surprised that none of us American teenagers were watching the coronation. Like, what did you expect? Oh, this is just where that waterfall area goes, isn't it? Yeah. Say the ground type friends. Okay. Very nice. Wow, okay. Let's go. Zen headbutt. Nah. Psychic type is not a good move, or not a good type for coverage. Because let's see, Psychic is good against poison and fighting, and that's it. You're ghost type, so you're naturally good against fighting, and you resist poison, and you have a ground type move, so no, Zen Headbutt would not be good. Coverage. Oh, crap. Wow, I got an Omni Boost from the Ominous Wind. That does more. Cool. No, you're a physical attacker. Why would I want... No. Why do I want Dragon Pulse? Like, seriously, compare your attack and special attack. I think that's the biggest difference on the team. Relatively close. Pretty big difference, but not as big as that. Look at that. Special attack is definitely higher, but still, like, let's see, 37 points apart. Special attack is just about double. Your special attack is almost, your physical attack is almost triple your physical attack. We can keep doing this, man. I've played this game too much. Actually, Golurk, you're gonna switch into Gulligan, and you were gonna use Earthquake to murder everyone. The Surf and Earthquake combo. Awesome. Thanks, man. Not an Oko. That's weird. Beating me is easy? Is that so? Is that what you say? Lucian. So, a fun fact I found out the other day, so, I've pretty much always known that, all of the Eevees have one stat that's base 130, and the rest of their stats. They have one base 110, one base 90, and then it's like 65, 65, 55 or something like that. I don't know if that's exactly what it is for the remaining ones, but they have one stat that's 130, one stat that's 110. But there are 8 evolutions and there are only 6 stats. So the 2 stats that are repeated are the 2 special stats. Special defense is repeated between Umbreon and Sylveon, and special attack is repeated between Glaceon and Espeon. That's what it is. I think this one's Adamant. That was the orb. Or no, it's Spatial. Yeah, Spatial, there we go. The last one's Grecious, that's what it is. See? So back in the earlier generations, Thunderwave was 100% accurate. So there is some NPC that's trying to give you the move tutor for Thunderwave, and they say, like, but Thunderwave is consistent! And it's funny, because now it has, like, 80% accuracy or something like that. Alright, so this fight is going to be tough, because it is against the Creation Trio. So I'm going to get you, because they're all dragon types. I'm going to take off Stabbing for right now. Oh yeah, okay. Nice. Color change may change to the ice type, you say. Cool. Alright. So actually, would be good for you is like a ground type. Oh my gosh, that did a lot. Or actually, yeah, that's doing a lot. Oh, you nerd. Very nice. You're gonna use... Okay. Yeah, you thought I was gonna stay at low HP, didn't you? Can I just take it out? I can. Awesome. Palkia. I'm hoping you don't have... Actually, do I have any, like, revives or anything? I have 2 max revives. Who'd be best against Palkia? What's it even weak to? Dragon. But Fracture's not faster, even if it could Oko. Fairy. Nobody on the move, on the team currently has a fairy move. I'm just gonna open prey. Yeah, that's fine. Actually, it's not fine because it's doing over half, but. Takes me all the way back to here, wow. Do I have any anybody trained up that knows like a fairy move? You do. Granbull. There you go. Who do I take off for now? Take off. No, you helped. I'll take off Goldberg for now. I'm smart sometimes. The big thing is to take out Dialga before I bring in, big thing is to take up Dialga before I bring in Granbull, because Granbull's weak to steel. So, if I can get Dialga out of the way, I think Granbull should be able to handle the rest. By the rest, I mean the other two. All the other two of them. So I'm going to put Golurk in first, because he can hopefully take out the Dialga. Yeah? Okay. Shelton. There we go. Granbull. Holy snap. That did a lot. Well, okay. Power Jam. I mean, on the offhand, yeah, I'm not faster, but okay. Yeah, okay. Wait, who can take care of Giratina? It has Ghost Move to deal back with you. I'm gonna hope Granbull can. Shadow Ball does so much. Okay, I need like a clean switch in, so I'm gonna go ahead and max revive you. And then I'm gonna max revive you so that I can get a clean. Oh my gosh, you survived? Okay, Covet, please. Do a lot. That didn't do a lot. Well, that... Creation Trio's tough. Maybe I'm not just not high enough level, because, like, you're the only one that's at 45. I feel like if I got a Haxorus, I could do this. So, get ready for the video chapter that just says grinding on it, guys. So I'm gonna train Granbull up to 45 or 50, and then I'm also gonna get a Haxorus. Okay, I'm back. So, I'll show y'all what I did. So, you learned crunch. Your moveset stayed the same. You just switched the moves back around, but yeah. You got Earthquake, which is cool. You got Will-O-Wisp over Psybeam, which you weren't using anymore. You evolved to Haxorus, and you got Playrough, which was also probably part of the problem, because Covet has a base power of 60. So. Now there's the problem of we have to defeat Mew right after. It's not like an easy fight or anything. The Mew fight right after we fight the Creation Trio. I mean, it's like a fully powered Mew at level 50. Also, I've just noticed that our Haxorus is actually a girl. Look at that. Look at that attack stat, though. You're the next highest. It's almost 30 points lower. Oh yeah, we need to go back and get the Genesect afterwards. Okay, let's try and do this. Much better now that we're actually like comparable in levels. Oh. It's not gonna do anything, and then Granbull. Nice! Awesome. Good job, Granbull. Oh. Well, maybe I was wrong. the last time that we'll actually see Luke. Thanks for all our help in like research and whatever. Did he just give us Waterfall? Is that what happened? Oh, Dive, okay. Yeah. You can't learn Dive? Blitzel probably can. So. I'm gonna put Blitzel in for you right now. And then for just a second, I'll take you off the team. Just so we can go get Genesect. Well, that would have been helpful. Unmaker. Imagine only being level 40. Can't fly from here. Actually. Very cool. That's a weird animation. Feels like Bone Club. Probably is, or Bone Meringue. What's this over here? Oh. I'll have to be sure to remember that after I get Waterfall. Boatzel, can you learn dive? Yeah. Let's go. I'll get rid of Aqua Jet. You're already really fast. Right? Yeah, you are. You are 12 levels lower than everybody else on our team. How do you compare speed-wise? Only slower than Haxorus. Do I have anything to sell? No? Okay. What are the trade stones for? I don't remember why I bought these. Is there anybody else in here that needs like a trade stone? Don't think so. Alright. There's a lady under there. Hey, nice undersea cavern. Oh, well. Is this all that's down here? What's the point of that, having that there? Darkwood Grotto? Alright, hello. There's that. Yeah. Okay. Endure. That's gonna do you a lot of good. Nice. That was a lot of effects at once. Hold on. I gotta see that animation again. So it has the tarts and also little confusion birds. You know, like the birds that are around your head when you're confused. The birds of confusion. Also known as every bird, because they're pretty weird. Nice full restore. I feel like that's probably the way to the exit, right here. It is. We found Darkwood Town. I'm gonna go explore the rest of that area then. Breloom! That's probably the worst Breloom I've ever done. Breloom! It's not getting any better. It's getting better all the time. Alright. What's the point of that? I do actually kind of want a Skrilp. Skrilp are cool. Or Dragalge is cool. Already got you. Skrilp? Anywhere? I said that at exactly an hour into the video. I just looked down at my recording time. Counting the grinding section, you know. Ah, there you are. Hopefully you have more than 40 health. Yeah, you do. Nice. Skrull. You gotta roll the R. Nice black belt. That powers up fighting moves. I would actually like to train Haxorus in attack. How's that? Oh, it's because of the different evolutions. That's pretty cool. Man, that's actually a pretty good way of grinding if it didn't cost $1,000. Actually, hold on. You get $640 every time you win. So after two battles, you've more than made back your winnings. Or your what you paid. So. So hold on, I have 27,000 right now. Wait, HP. Crap. I clicked too fast. Okay. Lotsal. Imagine I lose. Oh, your Pokemon's health is restored every time. Oh, probably still has the experience here, don't you? Yeah, you do. I did that to make grinding easier because I was grinding against Tangelas, and so. Tangela's not a Delibird, so it would have been kind of annoying to fight with Shelton, since he has grass and ground moves, which are both resisted or immune by everybody that I was training against. I mean, he does also have Rock Smash, but that's real weak, so. Crunch. Okay. If I had like a Dusknoir or something, I would actually want to train it in HP, but. Like water absorb or something, probably. Okay. Yeah, it does gain you money. So this is an amazing way of training right here. You just can't turn your brain off as much because you have to reselect what stat you want to train in. Every so many rounds. How did I not know about this until now? This is awesome. Man, I'm getting so many EVs. And so much money. Like $6,000 every time you do this. I will take it. Well, let's see. That'd be $6,400 every time. So $5,400 every time you do this. That's a good deal right there. I'll swap you out for now. Gotta fight Percy again. Alright, we can do that with our EV-trained Haxorus. Something I've never said before. Because, like, yeah, I play competitive Pokemon. I play Smogon, though, where it's a battle simulator. So... Good job, Percy. Waterfall. Okay, man. What's your attack set at now? Very high. Futsal, you're now my water HM Pokemon. Oh, you probably need to beat the gym first, don't you? It's a fighting type gym. Going angle again. Kinda rhymed. Going angle again. I can also use Delphox. Should have stuck with Gulligan. Okay, Breloom. That'll stay in, one shot it. Gallade. Golurk. Cario, I'll stay in. see how Earthquake does. All of it. Good to know. Nice. Did he even ever use a potion? I don't know if he did. That's pretty funny. So now I can use Waterfall. Which means... Where's... Geminite? Yeah. I can see what's in this area over here. Item. Which is a nugget. I would assume that a legendary Pokemon spawns there at some point. That's what it looks like to me. I am afraid to go in those doors right now because I am not equipped to catch a legendary Pokemon. That is going to be a big part of this series, by the way, is just catching all the legendary Pokemon I can find. There's a page on the Pokemon BlazBlazed wiki that tells you where all the legendaries are. I'm probably going to be consulting that heavily. But now, we're on the road to... the Pokemon League. I must be really strong because I made it up a waterfall. I mean, yeah, I guess you do have to defeat that guy. I don't know how you defeat him with just a Tentacruel, though. I mean, it makes sense, because Tentacruel resists fighting moves, but, like, doesn't have anything against them, unless you taught it... Like, I don't even know what you would teach a Tentacruel that's good against fighting types. Oh, yeah, I want to see a very easy way to get random encounters. You just hold up there. Old Amber. Ah, it's a fossil that I can revive. Very cool. What's up? Parish Song Politoed. Now that's a name I've not heard in many years. I don't know him, he's not me. What's the point, I ask again? What you got? His name Iroh? Like from Avatar? Great show, by the way. The Last Airbender? Very good show. Ace Trainer, Tourist, cool. Are there any, like, Ace Trainer class guys in this game? Couldn't tell you. Nice crit. I was expecting to die there, being completely honest. Oh, Mount Furnace, got it. You catch some legendaries there. Ah. I don't know if I still need Water Age gems or not, but for now... should I put Granbull back on the team, or should I switch in? I'll put Stabum back on the team for now. What do you have? Why do you have a Lepaberry? That's weird. You do have pickup, okay. Oh, hi, Shell. I've played through this. I've, like, beaten this game 3 times. Almost 4. And I never remember when Shell's, like, about to show up. Yeah, you can keep doing that. I mean, put away your own health. Don't make me do it. You know, it's really super effective. Yeah. Guy in an orange suit was looking for me. So I think you're supposed to think that's Henry. It's actually Michael. What's up, creator of game? Jolteon. Thought you had a Manectric. Breloom. I like Breloom. If it wasn't obvious by my, let's see. Channel icon somewhere, wherever my channel is, on the YouTube page. Okay. Good strategy. You do have a Manectric, okay. But you also have a Jolteon. That's bad type diversity. Nice. You can't rest here? Okay. I mean, there's a Pokemon Center lady right there, but I, whatever. Yeah, you're like the only special attacker I have, really, I guess. So, you're also a special attacker, but 145, 113, so you're mainly bulky. Actually, no, you have better bulk, too. What are you here for? Are you faster? No. Dang, you're really... Dang, you have a speed of 145? Golly. Dilphox is a really good Pokemon. So Haxorus obviously wasn't actually in, you know, Pokemon Emerald, so they gave it not to Scry. Neat. Just looking at the different lighting on my face. Alright. So. Crest Badge. I don't even know which badge is which. That's probably the water one. Stem badge? Yeah, there we go. So that's the grass one. Dead. You're dead. It's no surprise. Okay. What do you want? Trevenant. Trevenant's a really cool Pokemon. Unfortunately, it kind of sucks, but it is a really cool Pokemon. Nice freeze. Wish you had planned a picnic somewhere else. Why'd you plan the picnic in the middle of Victory Road? Or what's basically Victory Road? Gosh dang it. Can you fly from here? No. I need to know. That wasn't worth it. One minute. Okay. Is there anything back here, or is it just for fun? It's just for fun. There's a lot of areas like that on the map. It's like, yeah. You can go here if you want to. You have the freedom to do so. So I never really minded HMs, because I usually have all the, like, specifically, like, surf and fly, because, you know, like, I'm gonna have a water type in my team usually, but it is kind of annoying whenever, like, specifically in Pokemon Pearl, you need Waterfall to get back from Victory Road. And so, it's really annoying to always have to have that same Pokemon that knows Waterfall when you're going down to Victory Road to train up other people. Because you can't train up all your team at once, like, efficiently, if that Waterfall user isn't on your team. So it's kind of annoying. That being said, Pokemon Generation 4 is my favorite generation, so. That's weird. But did it have, like, I didn't read fast enough. Did it have, like, a berry or something? No. terrible pun. Yep, it's Michael. How are you people up here? Yeah, you notice I switched Torterra to the front so that I could just... I wonder if you can release him. I'm not gonna try. Are we gonna have another battle? No, okay. So here's the real victory road. Do I have, like, the TM for Earthquake? Oh, I'm dumb. I do not have the TM for Earthquake. I'm pretty sure it's number 26. I would totally teach Haxorus Earthquake. Given that I had it. I feel like the victory road is actually pretty short in this game. I mean, to be fair, Emeralds isn't, like, super long either, but it's longer than this. Who needs ladders when you can climb mountains? People who don't feel like climbing mountains. Very cool. Do you seriously need waterfall? I am guessing so. Speaking of TM Earthquake, very nice. Okay, that's where that waterfall goes, so It's not essential. I'm bad at directions. As evidenced by my final Pokemon Emerald episode, if y'all saw the hat. Why does this cave have to be so irksome? That's literally what it's... Okay. I mean, it's the final test, so... You would hope that there are, like, strong people in here. I don't know if that's exactly what they meant, but, like... I don't know, it seems like a weird thing to complain about. When you're the one sitting in a cave, not, like, actually trying to get out, you're just standing there for the rest of eternity. Dead. Is that it? Nice. Thought there was another battle. Sligoo. Dead. Feraligatr. Dead. Porygon Z. Dead. Manectric dead. That it? Cool. Okay, I think I'm gonna stop and save here for today. Till next time, be sure to like, subscribe, share the video. Thank you guys for all the support on the recent video. Specifically that I got 100 views, which is high for me. None of my videos have gotten that many views in like 3 or 4 years, so thank you. Be sure to like and subscribe, share the video with your friends, join the Discord, follow me on Twitch, all that fun stuff, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.